Hello everyone, welcome back to the class. I hope you all are absolutely fine and enjoyed your quality time with your parents. Also, you studied so that you need to prepare for your upcoming exam or test. Okay, so today our new topic, let's move to the new topic, that is computer network. What is network? Every time all of you have heard this term network, but what it is actually, network is, it is a connection, okay? So connection between some devices which connects two or more devices. So the very common example that we can deal with the network that you can take as an example is the ATM machine by which we can withdraw and deposit money in it. And every day, like many peoples are booking their air tickets, railway tickets. This is also with the help of networking. One more common example you can take, that is the cable TV network. That because of the cable TV connection, you are able to see the channels that has been provided by you by the cable TV service. Okay, so these all are the examples of network. So what actually is the definition of network or computer network is, when a computer network or simply network means when two or more devices connected together to form a network, or in the form to share resources or among themselves, that is known as computer network. You can see here in this figure, 1, 2, 3, 4 machines are connected to each other. But what is the purpose of the connection? What is the purpose of establishing this relation? It is just to share the resources among them. And the resources or the files may be the video, text, photos, pictures, anything. This to share these things among themselves, they form a network. This is known as computer network. Means a network, a computer network, when two or more interconnected devices are interconnected. And devices may be mobile and computer. Like suppose these two, three computer, one mobile device, it may be one printer, it may be. So not necessary that only computer should connect it. When these devices connected and they form a network and they can share resources or files among themselves, that connection is known as computer network. Fine. Now, what are the, by this connection you can easily conclude the advantages, that what are the advantages of computer network. The first advantage is resource sharing. Resource sharing means what? See, suppose here one printer is there. Okay. Now what will happen? Do we need, suppose I want to print data from one machine. So do we need individual printer connected to each the machine? No, that is not required in case of networking. If only one printer is there and this printer is connected to this machine and all other machines are connected, interconnected to with each other. So by the help of this connection, the printer can be shared among all the machines, or the data from all the machines can be printed very easily by this single printer. This is how the network, communication network or computer network works. Okay, no need to buy or individual printer for this. So it saves because since we need not have to buy 4 printer for 4 machines. So here one advantage comes, that is cost effective, means it is saving cost also, isn't it? As because we by sharing only one printer, we can easily print file from all other machines. And if this printer is connected to this machine, then individually these machines will send data to this machine, and from there it can easily print the files from all other machines. Okay, so two advantages come here: resource sharing, cost effective. Okay, one resource sharing cost effective, you can say, The next is reliability. Reliability means the since these four machines are interconnected with each other, so data from four they form a network. So data from if any machine get lost from data get lost from one machine, then we can easily get that data from other machine also, as because they are connected. So this is the one more advantage, that is reliability. We can easily get the amount of lost data. Okay, next is communication medium. Communication medium means what? Communication medium, what happened in this case, we can easily see that by establishing this network, a manager can easily communicate with all, easily create the report and send it to all other parts of the machines. Okay, so that other can, its his employee can easily get those data. So this is how, and it since this connection, because of this connection, the speed is also very much high. Okay, so these all are the advantages of computer network. Since it is having advantage, some disadvantages are also there. Disadvantage means to establish this setup, we need to hire a well software engineer who is more familiar with these matters. So the cost is, we need to provide him also the money, isn't it? Now the entire setup is also very costly. To make this setup, it is quite costly. So this is, it is very high chargeable. Now one more thing, if any, suppose here it is a central hub or they are connected with the server, if the server or the hub from where this they are getting the network get failure because of some reason, then what will happen, the whole system will get disturbed and it will stop working in a smooth way. Okay, so these all are the disadvantages related to computer network. Now next, move to type of network. I'll be providing you notes that you need to write down in your copy. So this is just for to make you clear about what the thing is. Okay, now next is types of network. Types of network. Number one is PAN. Number two is LAN. Three is MAN. And four is WAN. So now here we are going to discuss four types of network. Generally this three, it is in your syllabus, but I will discuss this PAN also. The PAN, the full form is personal area network. Okay, personal area network, then local area network, then metropolitan area network, then wide area network. Try to understand, students, here the difference between all these four types of network. What happened in this case? PAN, personal area network, means the network or the connection that established between 10 meter of distance. Suppose you are in a room, we are sharing data from one mobile device to another mobile device. By what? By sharing Bluetooth, infrared. So this is a PAN connection, PAN network connection, means within a very short distance the network connection that has been established, that is PAN. So 10 meter distance. So next is LAN. In PAN, this more examples, more day-to-day life example also you can take, that is the TV remote that we are accessing. Okay, again AC remote means those remote that are connected far within a 10 meter of distance. So that those all comes under PAN, personal area network. Now LAN, local area network. LAN is a type of network connection, so that can be work within a building, or you can say up to 2 to 3 kilometers it will work. Suppose if you are in the first floor and someone is in the second floor, so the network can be shared within first floor to second floor to third floor, means within 2 to 3 kilometers this network, 2 to 3 kilometers, then the connection that can be established, that is, that comes under local area network. Okay, next is MAN, metropolitan network. Area network. In LAN, in MAN, several LANs get connected to establish the connection of MAN. Several LANs get connected, okay, and it must be up to, you can say, 40 kilometer, up to 40 to 50 kilometer distance. This network can manage to share its data. Okay, so the very common example for MAN is cable TV network, right? The cable TV network, see, you can see from the cable office, they can easily provide their network from to all the city. So this is MAN connection, means up to 40 kilometer the network that has been established, or by which we can share data, that comes under MAN. Next is when several LANs and MANs get connected to create WANs. WANs span for geographical, large geographical area, you can say, to continent, to country, to separate country, like internet connection. Internet connection means you are sitting in one country and you want to share your data to another country, to your friends. So we are using WAN connection, that is internet connection that we are using, that comes under WAN. Okay, one more thing now, see, LAN and MAN difference is that not only because of the distance. Now the similarity is that LAN can share its data within a city, within the same city, and MAN also can share data within the same city. But the difference is that LAN can share data from within the same building to a campus 2 to 3 kilometers, whereas MAN up to 40 kilometers, means within the, it almost covers a whole city. Okay, so this is the difference between LAN and MAN, and similarity is they both of them must be within the same city. Now one question, see, suppose you are standing, you are working in the border of Delhi, you are and someone is outside the Delhi border, means you can say in UP, in the border, this side is Delhi and that side is UP. So can you examine, or can you guess that which network will work on this? Now see, just now I told you that it should be, LAN should also be in the same city, and MAN also should also in the same city. But since there is a border, and border, this side is Delhi and that side is, you can say, Mumbai, or you can say in Haryana, then what happened that city is not same, because states, it will happen that states are different. They are not in the same city, then they are obviously WAN will work, not this LAN and MAN. Right? Okay. Now this is all about the types of network. There are 4 types of network: PAN, LAN, MAN, WAN. I'll be sending you the details, notes, along with the differences between these 4. So you just need to go through it. In the next class, we'll start a next new topic. Okay, but before that, you have to be very much clear with these things, because these things will be going to come, and the very short questions will be